I thought that one thing to do with the written word was to pretend that it was an object that could be bent. An object that tells of the loss, destruction, disappearance of objects, does not speak of itself. Think of the city, the edge of the city, and the traffic there. So anyway, when I was small, I was very good at hiding. In zoology, hiding is called crypsis. Hiding takes practice. We had moved from the city in the wintertime to a new house in the woods, a mile from anyone at all. And whenever I asked my brother what he wanted to do, he'd say, "Let's hide. Let's hide, man." Cuando jugamos al escondite, when we played hide and seek, he was happy. ¿Por qué nos gustara escondernos tanto? Yo no lo sé. Why did we like hiding so much? I don't know. So anyway, my father was happy there until spring. But then the frogs began calling. There were so many, and they were so loud. We thought at first it was monsters or people from outer space. But then we got used to it and went to sleep. But my father couldn't sleep that night, or any night from then on. Around midnight, he got up and went outside with a flashlight and some rocks from the driveway. He was out there a long time trying to hit them, make them shut up. But the frogs didn't care a thing about a man with flashlights. They just hid out. And as soon as he went back inside, they started to call again. So he told me and my brother, $1 for every frog to kill. $1 was a lot of money in those days. We wanted to save up for a 55 DeSoto. In the ads it said, "Here is a car that translates your wishes into action, almost with the speed of thought itself." So anyway, we stalked them. But although we speared them with sticks, we tipped with finishing nails and shot them with a BB gun, a daisy. We only got the young and foolish ones. As it grew dark, we would wait in the silence, hoping we'd hit the grandfathers at last, but no. As soon as it was dark enough to suit them, they began to call. You know why they're doing that, my brother asked me? It's because they're horny. We thought that was pretty cool. Frogs might be slimy and have eyes that stick way out like pimples, but pimples you can see with. But they understand what's important in life, and they understand how to hide. I learned how to hide from them. In order to hide, you don't just get under something or behind something. You become something else. Then no one can get you. You don't even exist anymore. The old ones knew how to become some water or a piece of darkness. We'd walk right past them every time. The Chinese used to believe that the earth sits on an enormous frog. The Egyptians had a goddess with the head of a frog. Her name was Hecate. Scientists say frogs are the first animals to evolve a true voice. And frogs are ancient symbols of fertility and ease. I used to wonder, why do they get so mad? It was my mother's pond anyway. She gave the man on the bulldozer $10 to dig a hole. The next day it was full of water. She imagined a blue circle with cattails and dragonflies. But it was dirty brown all summer, and all summer we filled it with the floating corpses of silent frogs. When it was hot, it was stink. So anyway, at last, My father couldn't stand it anymore. They seemed to get louder and louder every night. Scientists have discovered by experiments that a female frog will move closer to the male frog who calls the loudest, goes on for the longest, and whose call is the most elaborate. That's the one she wants to propagate with, they found. So anyway, one day he borrowed a shotgun. It was an August night, dark and hot. We were out there with our spears. My brother saw him coming. He said, man, let's hide. You could tell he really wanted to kill something. He blasted away every time he heard a single peep. He destroyed the cattails and the turtles, and he terrified the dragonflies. Got a little sapos abuelitos. They were still there. The neighbors called the police. They came and took the gun away. And gave him a lecture that made him mad. He was not really a very happy man, my father. He didn't like getting up in the dark to go to work. He didn't like his job anyway. But he had to work hard to support his kids. He had a lot of kids. He didn't really like kids. But he was married, so he had them. He didn't really like the sour, angry woman he married either, but anyway, those were the rules. He did what he was supposed to. What did it matter how you felt about anything? Before the war, my father had been a musician. After the war, he came home. All his music was gone. His father had given his saxophone away to the Goodwill store. Time to grow up. He went back to college to get some kind of career. He was lonely. He met someone. He started learning how to hide. Think of the edge of the city. So